Dear family, I wanted to explain why I am sitting here doing an interview and a video on behalf of myself and you. On your behalf, on the basis that I would like you, at least those who know me, or those who are still to who know very little of me, know a little bit more about my life. A lot of it is very, very odd. There are mices, odds and ends, which normally don't come, as far as I know, into a history of anybody. But I hope that you will not be bored, and at least for the next generation, they will listen to it. What they do after that, God alone knows. I hope this video will convince you that you have a grandfather, and of whom you can be proud, and especially because of Yich he gives to you. In a way, I'm sorry that I didn't listen more to the stories of my father and mother. But I should tell you, and you probably don't know, we've had what we call, I had an ancestor called Bubba Khanna, I think it was. No. She then lived to the age of 106, and she died while being transported during the First World War. And they lived in Lithuania in a small village called Sakot. My mother and my father came out here to South Africa at the age of 20. My mother came out 10 years later. She was 10 years younger. She came to marry him. It's the usual story that happened from Jewish families. The men came to South Africa and they worked hard and until they were able to marry, and they sent back home to a bride. And who comes from the bride? Who were the brides? Members of the family. And that's why my mother and father were cousins. My father, when he came out, it was the Boer War in 1901 or something. And he had all sorts of jobs, and he ended up at the military camp in Weinberg there. And eventually he became a butcher, and he made a living, and then when he called my mother back. And what happened there, apparently, he didn't know my mother. She must have been about 12 years old when he left. And you know, in those days, a totally different thing to today. In those days, you left and said goodbye to the family. It was permanent, really permanent. And they went, so the only communication was by letter. And after a while, you just didn't write letters anymore. And you lost track. Anyway, there's my father and mother came out. My father, he taught himself English and to read and write. And my mother, she didn't bother. And I think all her life she must have been at a disadvantage. I understood from my father's stories that his father, had a mill, a water mill, and that he got strangled on the mill over there. That's the story I remember of the past. But coming back to my mother, my father thought that the elder sister, Rose, would be coming out. But she had already gone to America to join someone there. And so they said, my mother, and as far as I can make out, you know, There was no such thing as divorce in those days or anything. And it's like, it's the same thing as what's fiddler on the roof. Do you love me? I don't know. Over the years, they had a good life together. My father's name was Morris Meyerowitz in English. In English, my mother's name was Rebecca Freelander. I think my mother was quite a beautiful woman. Yeah, I didn't think in those terms, of course. But I'm looking at her. Yeah, she was.
And your dad was a kind man.
She was a very good housewife. Yeah, my father made a living. We were I never felt poor that we couldn't. Yeah. He was generous with us.